Going on, everyone. Welcome, Rabbit here. And on my little test bench area here, I have two 5900Xs, which I got to get tested and out of here because I keep blowing my breakers. And then I got the 4090 in now. So I really don't have any extra power in my workstation room at all. So I'm going to shut these off. I'm going to set the power supply up to just one rig here, the 5900X. Now we're going to be testing Zeph Random X hash rates. And as you guys know, you've seen a lot of my videos and CPU mining in the past. We're going to rock two sticks of RAM for Random X because it does love its low latency memory. This is CL16 3200 megahertz RAM, the same RAM I used on my past 3900 test. So I just want to go through those numbers because that's the main thing I want to see here. Is, you know, how is the 5900X compare to the 3900X? And if you missed the 3900X video, these are the numbers with the CL16 RAM. And at 3.7 gigahash, 0.98 volts, which I don't have written down here, but that's what it's at. You can go double check the video if you want. But we are getting 13.5 kilohash at 132 watts. Now the 5900X actually have 100 hertz slower of a base clock speed over the 3900X. So we're gonna see how it's gonna play out here. I'll jump into the BIOS. We'll look at the current settings here, but we're gonna figure out what is the better buy, the 39 or the 5900X for Zeph mining, as well as Monero, Yada coin, and all those other coins that do use RandomX. It's all gonna be the same hash rates and power consumption. Okay, so on the 5900X, you can see we are at 3.7 gigahertz, which is the base clock of this CPU. The 3900X has a base clock of 3.8, but in my testing, I was running them at 3.7. And we have our DDR speed, our RAM is at 3200 megahertz. XMP profile is turned on profile one. And you can see the CPU voltage is 0.9875, which is the same thing I had set on the 3900X with this exact same RAM. So we're shooting for around 132 watts and 13.5 kilohash. Let's see what we get.
All right, guys. So in the dashboard here, we can see we're doing about 12.7 kilohash or 12,753 hashes. That is about 700 or 800 hashes less than the 3900X. And it's doing it at more power. We're coming in at 137 watts as well. I am pretty disappointed in the 5900X for this. Now, I don't even know what to say about it. You know, I was expecting to be at least the same and hopefully a little bit better, but it's looking like it might not be.
All right, guys, so that was a little bit of disappointment. Now, obviously, it comes down to price. Do you buy a 3000 series or a 5000 series? Whatever's the cheapest you can find. But it has been looking like the 3000 series has been the better CPU. We're going to see what happens when the 8000 releases for over the 7000 series that we have right now, as the 7900 and 7950Xs are absolute beasts for CPU mining. If the 8000 series, if they do what they did with the 5000 series here, where it's pretty much everything's exactly the same, but they increase the boost clock for gamers and decrease the base clock by that 100 hertz, then it's looking like the 7000 series will probably be the better option moving into the future after the 8000. And they'll probably come in a lot cheaper because it's the older gen. So gamers like to dump all that and say they have the next best hardware. So we could see a nice 7000 series spike moving forward. But looking at this 3000 versus 5000, it is looking like the 3000 series is the better CPU. Now, maybe I just have bad silicon or something here. Now, when I turned this one on and did the same thing, because I initially did these tests by myself a while back, I just didn't record them or anything, but now I'm doing like a little recording here. This was performing exactly the same as this one. So it has nothing to do with this specific rig. They both have the same RAM. They both use everything exactly the same as the previous, minus the coolers. These are different coolers here. So maybe the coolers are using, these fans could be using a bit more power than when I was using the Wraith Prism when I tested that out. But regardless, the point is these are seeing a little bit less hash than the 3900X. So again, just a cross reference here, the 3900X on the CL16 10 nanosecond RAM was doing 13.5 kilohash at 132 watts. And now this, where we got here? Oh, right there. The 5900X is the one little line in there at 3.7, same clock settings, 2.6. And CL16 3200 XMP turned on, we're getting 12,753 hashes at 137 watts. So 5 extra watts and 800 less hashes. So are you guys currently mining on the 5900X? I am curious to know what your hash rate is, as well as possible power consumptions. Now, I got these fairly cheap. They're only like $299 or $399 Canadian on Black Friday sales, plus everything else, obviously. But they're on sale. It's not too bad. I haven't tested this CPU yet, so it was nice to get my hands on these. I still got to test out all the other algorithms as well right quick. I got two 7900X rigs that are almost in that I got a complete building. Once all the parts are in, I got to get some stands printed and all that stuff. So I got to get these things tested and the heck out of here and find some room for them. And then I got to start building those rigs. And then I got to get everything out of here because I keep blowing up some breakers. So thank you for checking out this video, guys. It's looking like 3000 does outperform the 5000 series when it does come to CPU mining. I'll see you on the next one. Rabbit out.